The Twitter account UNH Blackout delivers on what its anonymous host asks, to tweet pictures of what appear to be others most unflatteringly passed out after binge drinking.
I think it's funny to see, but like I know if I was on it or like I saw someone I knew, I'd be like, ooh.
I definitely wouldn't want to be seen on it at all. Definitely wouldn't want my friends to be on it.
While they may hit delete some point in their life, when they leave the university environment and try to get a job, it's going to be there.
Concerns about the permanence of social media postings aside, Durham's police chief says binge drinking on college campuses is a nationwide problem, and that about 92% of their arrests have some alcohol involvement.
Very intelligent people who are going to the University of New Hampshire and are excited to be here sometimes make, you know, poor choices when alcohol consumption is involved.
The university issued a statement. We regularly encourage and educate our students to be safe and smart online and are disturbed by websites that in any way glorify alcohol or drug use. Any criminal behavior will be investigated if brought to the attention of the UNH Police Department. Emergency responders in Durham are no strangers to calls about extreme intoxication and the reality that the body can shut down.
They fall asleep, they pass out. Next thing that can happen is their heart rate can slow, their pulse can slow down, and their heart can stop. They can stop breathing. Respiratory arrest usually happens first. I've seen those before.
Some hope that exposure of the site might serve as a wake-up call, while others worry about the publicity.
I think it's a little vulgar and doesn't really represent the UNH community all that well.
Reporting from Durham, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.
Publicity over the site may be causing the anonymous host to have second thoughts. A tweet from the account yesterday said that it wants to delete the Twitter handle, but can't remember the password.